إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. عباد الله، أوصيكم بتقوى الله عز وجل، فإن بالتقوى تنال السعادة. O servants of Allah, I advise you with the taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jal, because verily, by practicing taqwa, you will obtain happiness. Everyone hopes, everyone wishes and wants good in this life and the next. Everyone suspects that what they do will bring them good. And this is the desire of everyone, even the kuffar. Allah Azza wa Jalla says about one of them, وَلَئِنْ رُدِدْتُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي لَأَجِدَنَّ خَيْرًا مِنْهَا مُنْقَلِبًا. And if I was to go back to my Lord, I would find better than this in exchange. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says about their statements, أَفَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي كَفَرَ بِآيَاتِنَا وَقَالَ لَأُوتَيَنَّ مَالًا وَوَلَدًا اطَّلَعَ الْغَيْبِ أَمِ اتَّخَذَ عِنْدَ الرَّحْمَنِ عَهْدًا كَلَّا. Allah Azza wa Jalla says about them, have you not seen the one who has disbelieved in our ayat? And he says, I will be given money and children. Has he seen that which is unseen? Or has he taken a covenant from Allah ar-Rahman? No, indeed not. Likewise, Allah Azza wa Jalla says about them, فَمَا لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا قِبَلَكَ مُحْطِعِينَ عَنِ الْيَمِينِ وَعَنِ الشِّمَالِ عِزِينَ أَيَطْمَعُ كُلُّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ أَن يُدْخَلَ جَنَّةَ نَعِيمٍ كَلَّا. Allah Azza wa Jalla says about them, so what is with the disbelievers coming to your direction, listening to make fun of you, standing on the right and the left in groups? Does each of them hope? Do they desire that they be allowed to enter gardens of pleasure? Indeed, no. So they hope and they desire ويتمنون. وليس للإنسان ما تمنى. But insan, human beings, they don't get simply what they want. You don't get what you want simply because you desire it. They have joy and they are pleased with what they have in this dunya, but their joy will be short-lived. كل حزب بما لديهم فرحون فذرهم في غمرتهم حتى حين أيحسبون أن ما نمدهم به من مال وبنين نسارع لهم في الخيرات بل لا يشعرون. Allah Azza wa Jalla says about them, every group delighted with what they have. So leave them in their drunkenness or their intoxication for a while. Do they think that which we give them from money and children is us hastening the good to them? أَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّمَا نَمُدُّهُمْ بِهِ مِنْ مَالٍ وَبَنِينَ نُسَارِعُ لَهُمْ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ بَلْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. Instead, they do not understand. Sometimes we find ourselves overjoyed with the things in this dunya. And we find ourselves delighted. And we have this hope from Allah Azza wa Jal. But we should not be misled by this temporary enjoyment that we see around us and see others in. Instead, these individuals will never obtain sa'adah. They will never obtain happiness because they didn't do what happiness mandates. Allah Azza wa Jalla says about them, لَا يَحْسُبَنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّمَا نُمْلِي لَهُمْ خَيْرٌ لِأَنفُسِهِمْ إِنَّمَا نُمْلِي لَهُمْ لِيَزْدَادُوا إِثْمًا وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, let not those who disbelieve think that what we give them is good for themselves. Verily what we give them is so that they can increase in sin, and for them is a severe punishment. Likewise, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, لَا يُغْرَنَّكَ تَقَلُّبَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا فِي الْبِلَادِ متاع قليل ثم مأواهم جهنم وبئس المهاد. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, don't be tricked by the goings and the comings of those who disbelieve on this earth. You see them coming and going in joy and in pleasure from what you perceive. Don't be tricked by that. For indeed, their ma'wa, the place that they will go back to, is Jahannam. And what an evil place to end up. These individuals who disobey Allah and His Messenger will never obtain sa'adah because they didn't do what happiness mandates. But Allah Azza wa Jalla says about those who implement taqwa, لَكِنَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي تَحْتَهَا الْأَنْهَارِ نُزُلًا مِّنْ عِمْدِ اللَّهِ وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ لِلْأَبْرَارِ. But those who have taqwa, but those who have taqwa of their Lord, they will have gardens underneath which rivers flow, and abode from their Lord, and what is with Allah is better for those who are righteous. This is the means of obtaining happiness, by implementing taqwa. Indeed, you will have what is better in this life and the next because of taqwa. And you will have happiness because of taqwa. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. Verily, the awliya of Allah, they will have no grief, nor will they have any worries. Those who used to have iman and they used to show taqwa. This is the means of obtaining happiness. So for this reason, those who disbelieve in Allah and His Messenger will never obtain it, because they didn't follow the path that will put them on happiness. And what is that path, you might ask? Indeed, that path is following the book and the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and not deviating from it and being steadfast upon it. This is how happiness is obtained, and this is the essence of taqwa. Allah Azza wa Jalla says about His book, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ. Indeed, this Quran guides to that which is most upright. And He says about this book, ألف لامين ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين. Alif Lam Mim. That is the book, i.e. this Quran. There's no doubt in it. A guidance for those who have taqwa. This taqwa is what allows you to obtain the guidance from the book of Allah. And what allows you to get this happiness. And since the people of taqwa were the only ones who benefited from the book, then those who disbelieve will never obtain happiness. But this is not exclusively for those who disbelieve. Indeed, O servants of Allah, sometimes we, in our life, we find moments of unhappiness and disgruntledness and frustration, and we're not pleased with the life that we're in, then we should understand that that is for no other reason than a deficiency in our taqwa. And that is for no other reason than a deficiency in our following the book and the sunnah. Every time you find yourself unhappy with your life, you find yourself frustrated with the dunya, uncontent, angry, worried, unsure, then this is for a deficiency in your adherence to the book and the sunnah. How could it not be? When Allah Azza wa Jalla told our father Adam, alayhi salatu wa salam, قال اهبطا منها جميعا بعضكم لبعض عدو فإما يأتينكم مني هدى فمن اتبع هداي فلا خوف فلا يضل ولا يشقى ومن أعرض عن ذكري فإن له معيشة ضنكا ونحشره يوم القيامة أعمى. الله عز وجل told our father Adam, after it occurred what occurred, he told him, as he said in the Quran, he said, go down from it, i.e. from the paradise, all of you. Some of you will be enemies to each other. But if it comes to you from me, a guidance, the book of Allah, the sunnah of his messenger, if it comes to you from me, a guidance, فَمَنِ اتَّبِعَ هُدَايَ, then whoever follows my guidance, فَلَا يَضُلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى, then he will never go astray, nor will he be unhappy. The more and more you follow the book of Allah, the less and less you'll be unhappy. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي, but whoever turns away from my reminder, you turn away from the Quran, إِنَّ نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكَرِ, you turn away from the sunnah, وَنَزَّلْنَا إِنَّ أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الذِّكَرْ لِتُبَيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ, when you turn away from this dhikr, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, فَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةٍ ضَنْكَ, and whoever turns away from my dhikr, then he will have a tight, a hard, a constricted life, and we will raise him on the day of judgment blind. Indeed, O servants of Allah, happiness is only obtained through the worship of Allah. Being steadfast upon it, not shaking, but being firm. Not being misled by that which you see to be good from the dunya, but understanding that what Allah has with him is better. Sometimes when an affliction befalls us, we go and we blame others. When something bad happens to us, we say, Wallahi, my wife did. Wallahi, my husband did. Wallahi, my friends, they did. Wallahi, it's this job. Wallahi, it's my car. But Allah Azza wa Jalla informed us that everything bad that happens to us, وَمَا أَصَابَ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسِبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ, and nothing afflicts you, or whatever afflicts you from afflictions, then it's because what your own hand sent forth. So what will you say on that day when these excuses and these blames who you want to cast won't benefit you? The day when the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said about it, فمن وجد خيرا فليحمد الله، ومن وجد غير ذلك فلا يلمن إلا نفسه. Whoever finds good on that day, then let him praise Allah. And whoever finds other than that, then let him not blame anyone but himself. Indeed, these afflictions are because of what we've abandoned from the book and the sunnah, and because of what we've not been steadfast upon the book and the sunnah. Because if you show taqwa, then you'll be successful. أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون. It is these who are on guidance from their Lord, and it is these who will be successful. But indeed, the failure in this life and the next is to not be steadfast upon the worship of Allah. Some people, they worship Allah when good happens. But when hard times come, when they lose their job, they don't make salah. They spend their day working harder and harder. It's too hard right now. I gotta make this money. I don't have time right now. When things get hard, they abandon the worship of Allah. Indeed, this is the failure that Allah warned us about. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى حَرْفٍ فَإِنْ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٌ اطْمَأَنَّ بِهِ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ فِتْنَةٌ انْقَلَبَ عَلَى وَجْهِهِ خَسِرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةَ ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينُ. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, from the people are those who worship Allah on the edge. If good befalls them, they're comforted by it. But if a fitna falls on them, they lose their job, they lose their money, they don't know how they're going to pay their rent, they're having problems with their family and their friends. If a fitna befalls them, انقلب على وجهه, he turns back on his face, he goes backwards. This individual has lost the dunya and the akhirah. This is the apparent loss. The more and more you abandon the book of Allah, the more and more you'll be in failure. As Allah Azza wa Jalla said, قُلْ هَلْ نُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا الَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعْيُهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ صُنْعًا أُولَئِكَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ وَلِقَائِهِ فَحَبِطَتْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ فلا نقيم لهم يوم القيامة وزنا ذلك جزاؤهم جهنم بما كفروا واتخذوا آياتي ورسلي هزوا. Allah Azza wa Jal, He says, shall we not inform you of the greatest of losers? Those who all their effort in this life is wasted, and they think that they're doing something good. They think that they're doing actions of value. It is these who have disbelieved in the ayat of their Lord, so their actions were rendered useless, and they will not have any scales established on the day of judgment. This is their recompense, Jahannam, because of what they disbelieve in the ayat of your Lord and His messengers, and they took them as gains. Indeed, O servants of Allah, we need to pay great attention to the ayat of our Lord in the book and the sunnah of His messenger, that we can avoid being from these losers. And understand that the more and more we worship Allah, the better and better our lives will become. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه. O servants of Allah, it's very easy for us to sometimes be distracted by what we see around us from the enjoyments of this dunya. We see individuals who disbelieve in Allah and His Messenger having things that we consider to be enjoyment. And sometimes we're distracted by the pleasures that we ourselves have in this life. The money, the family, the friends that we have. But it's important that we understand the statement of Allah Azza wa Jalla when He says, وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا لَعِبٌ وَلَهْوٌ وَلَدَارُ الْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لِلَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, verily, the life of this dunya is nothing more than a game and a joke. And verily, the next life is better for those who have taqwa. Will you not show any intellect? The smart individual understands that this life is fleeting. So he prepares for the life that will last forever. And he is not distracted by the fitna that he sees around him. Even if others perceive it to be good, he understands the statement of Allah, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ. And we will test you with evil and good things as a form of a fitna, and to us you will return. So for this reason, he pays no attention to that which he finds those individuals who disobey and join from this worldly life. And he puts his effort into the worship of Allah, as Allah Azza wa Jalla commanded him when he said, وَلَا تَمُدَّنَّ عَيْنَيْكَ إِلَى مَا مَتَّعْنَا بِهِ إِلَى مَا مَتَّعْنَاهُمْ بِهِ إِلَى مَا مَتَّعْنَا بِهِ أَزْوَاجًا مِّنْهُمْ زَهْرَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا لِنَفْتِنَهُمْ فِيهِ وَرِزْقُ رَبِّكَ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاصْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا لَا نَسْأَلُكَ رِزْقًا نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكَ وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلتَّقْوَى. He follows the commandment of Allah when Allah says, and don't stretch your eyes to that which we have given them to enjoyment from themselves, wives, flowers of this dunya, to cause them a fitna. And the provision of your Lord is more lasting. And he puts his effort in the worship of Allah, as Allah said, and command your family with salat, and be patient upon that. We don't ask for you to provide. We provide for you. And the end results will be for those that have taqwa. How many parents nowadays, we see they give their effort that their children get a good education, go to school, get A's and B's. And they figure that by doing this, they'll ensure a good life for their children. This is not the means to ensure a good life. Allah, He says, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ. Command your family with salah. We find them holding their children back from going to the masjid, from marrying at young ages, from being steadfast upon the book and the sunnah. Although Allah, He says, command your family with salah and be patient on that, we don't ask for you to provide. No matter what you do, Allah Azza wa Jal, He said, نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكُ. We provide for you. And the end result will be for those that have taqwa. This taqwa is the means to happiness. And this is the means to having a good life. That's why Allah says in the Quran a statement, and indeed the best speech is the speech of Allah. Allah, He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اِسْتَجِيبُوا لِلَّهِ وَلِلْرَسُولِ إِذَا دَعَاكُمْ لِمَا يُحْيِيكُمْ وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَحُولُ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَقَلْبِهِ وَإِنَّهُ إِلَيْهِ تُحْشَرُونَ. وَاتَّقُوا فِتْنَةً لَا يُصِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ خَاصَّةً وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ خَاصَّةً وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, O you who have iman, answer to Allah and His Messenger. Respond when they call you to that which will bring you life. Your life, the enjoyment that you'll have in it, is only found in answering the call of Allah and His Messenger. And have knowledge that Allah is in between, or is the yahulu between a person and his own heart. You have to put Allah first, besides all of your desires, because you have this knowledge that to Him you will return. And be worried of a fitna that doesn't afflict just those who were wrong from you. وَاتَّقُوا فِتْنَةً لَا يُصِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ خَاصَةً. And have knowledge that Allah is severe in His punishment. The only way to protect ourselves is with this taqwa. And this is what taqwa means, to protect yourself from Allah by doing righteousness. And this will assure you a good life. As Allah, He said, وَمَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبًا. Whoever works righteousness, whether male or female, and they have iman, then we will give them a good life. I ask Allah to give us all a good life by adhering to His book and His sunnah and being steadfast upon that. وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ.